Hello there, guys. Bilbo10000 here, bringing you The Legend of Zelda, the original game. Yes, I do have a save already made for this game. We're going to be playing the original Legend of Zelda, and that includes all of the farming before the first dungeon, which I'm hopefully going to get through in this first episode. I'll probably fast forward a few segments, literally just because it can take up a lot of time. We've got the old man's sword. Please don't go alone, take this. It's dangerous to go alone. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get the bombs, which is my first objective, because what I'm doing is I'm following the Zelda dungeon walkthrough of this, and I've wanted to play a Zelda game for a while on this channel, and this is basically my best chance to do it. So I thought, you know what, let's go for it. Let's play some Zelda. Let's kick some Zelda butt. Because, yeah, kicking Zelda is totally... I lost my sword beam powers. Come over, come here, Tektite. Ah. Did any of you guys ever see that, the original advert that advertised the original Legend of Zelda? That was beautiful. Can't get that rupee. This is where it gets difficult, because you have these guys, and these guys like to show up and be douchey. Although, there's also a bombable cave here, but we'll be coming back to that when we actually have the bombs. We need to go this way, but there's going to be more of these douches, so we just got to kind of just get rid of them. And look at that, gets us a lot of rupees as well, which we actually will need. This is a Octorok Central. These Octoroks take 2 hits to kill, and that one dropped bombs anyway. Brilliant. Now, I mean, I actually want to go and legitimately buy the bombs, though, because I believe you can get more than 4, so... Okay, let's try and kill you guys. Don't want you. Does not want. And definitely does not want. Okay, this is the furthest I've got without losing a life on this game. You see, the dungeons themselves are incredibly easy. It's the roundup to get to the dungeons that are incredibly tough. Oh, God. This is where it's going to go wrong. This is where it's going wrong. Okay, we need to kill this guy. Okay, let's go in here and let's get some bombs if we have the money. Hopefully we do. Oh, yep. Buy some, will ya? 20 bombs. Okay, let me just scroll down on my little walkthrough that I have next to the thing. You see, my game has actually paused. It's magic. It's a kind of magic. Okay, I've got like a little map of the Zelda universe, and it's just kind of like telling me where to go. Okay, so we're going to go back down here, and we want to go back to where I said there was that bombable cave. Which is off this way. We want to avoid the Zoras. Yes, Zoras are evil in this game. And just going to kind of head along. No enemies, because I've killed them, which definitely helps out a lot. Because the cave where we're going to has a heart container. And if you know your Zelda, then you know heart containers are good. So it's a choice, take the potion or take the heart container. If you take the potion, you'll never get all the heart containers in the game, and thus you'll be very, very stupid. I wanna go this way now. And now, why did I do that? I just wasted, arguably, a very helpful, oh god. These guys are gonna get annoying. Uh-oh. This isn't good, if I die, I swear to God, if I die, oh God damn it, I'm dead. Well, it's not too bad. We have the bombs, we have all that stuff, so we don't have to go back down the dangerous path. What we're gonna do is we're literally just gonna continue, and instead of going over to the dangerous path, we're just gonna go up from this room. And yeah, we do need to actually get a heart from one of these guys. Oh, that's a fairy. That's just as good, if not better. There we go, back to here. Not exactly there yet, but we're getting there. I think this is where Lake Hylia is, and the next dungeon is up from here, or this is the other lake, because there's 2 lakes. There's Lake Hylia, and then there's like a small lake that's near Lake Hylia. This is where we were. This is where we want to be. Nope. Okay. Want to take out you. Oh my god, that is beautiful. That is, I am getting some good luck today. Oh, that is also quite lucky. and just got to take you out. Basically, I need to take these guys out because I need to farm for rupees. Now, I'm actually going to look for some secret rupees in some secret areas, but until then, I do have to farm. Now, why did I do this? Why did I do that? That was stupid, and I've just lost my sword beam. Brilliant! Right, we need to go up here. And we need to take the right passage. And we need to go through the right here. Just kind of avoid the enemies. Just clamber up onto the next screen. We need to go right over here. Over here to the right, and we should be fine. So glad that we can block arrows. Okay, we need to move you. That's the early descendant of an Armos statue, and they're very famous. Now, this is a secret rupee. We can collect that for 10 rupees. Not too much, but you know what? Oh, that was beautiful. That was beautiful. Even if I didn't get much out of it, that was very beautiful. Alright, we need to go left. We need to go left. Oh, God. Okay. Okay, run. We need more hearts. That's what we need. Nope, that goes to another dungeon. We don't want to go that way. We want to go up. Haha. I'm smart. Trust me, I am smart. Oh god, it's the other one. There we go. Oh god. Let me in. I'm on half a heart. That's brilliant. That is really good. You know, half a heart. Really, really good. We need to bomb a wall up here. Let's see, what kind of enemies are we dealing with? Okay, in here is rock tektites, which we can deal with. They move a bit faster than normal ones, so we want to be kind of careful. Oh, and we're dead. Oh, no. Alright, so we need to get back there then. So, we're going to take the same route. I want to get all the gathering stuff done in this episode today. Probably going to do some jump cuts, just to make sure that I get everything done. Oh, I didn't want to get hit there. I really didn't want to get hit there. Okay, we need to kill you, and you, and you. And we need to kill you, and we just need to get rupees galore. We need one more heart to be able to use our sword beam, which is like the most effective weapon in the entire game ever. Ever. There we go. We can use our sword beam now. Hopefully we won't get hit straight away and have to lose our sword beam, because that would make me cry. Be sad. No. Oh. You better have a heart, mate. You better have a heart. Thank you so much. You're so kind, donating your heart. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up here, and I'm going to go right. Because we do need to go this way anyway, so... Now, I'm pretty sure going up will lead to a desert, but we don't want to go there because that's a dangerous area full of bad things. And that moblin's just going to keep shooting up, I assume, so... Okay. I can't kill them because I can't get over to them anyway, so no point. Go up. Alright, we have a decent amount of health this time. We can do this. We can do this. Up we go. We've been here before. We know what these guys are all about. We just need to sword beam them and you should be fine. So basically, in this early stages, sword beams are essential. And I just lost my sword beam. Don't matter. I'm in a pretty good position anyway, so... Or I wish I was in a pretty good position. The problem with this game is that controls are slightly finicky. I know I say that about most games, but this game, I feel like it's incredibly true. Let's bomb the wall, go in there, get some more rupees. Gonna get some secret rupees, don't know how many we're gonna get, but we're gonna get some. And then we're gonna go and get a heart container. 30 rupees, lovely! Let's go get a heart container from in here, don't know how long I've been recording for. Really hoping that my voice is actually recording and that I haven't just screwed up somehow, because that would be really bad. Actually, I really want to just quickly check if my... I am recording, yeah, that's good. How long are we recording for? 9 minutes, that's nothing. I could get everything done for the gathering in 9 minutes, so let's head down and see what we need to get this time. Ah, this is where we have to get all the special stuff. Yay. Alright, so straight away from here, we want to go right here. And we want to go, not the stairs, but we want to go around this way. Now we're going to meet P-Hats. P-Hats can only be oh my god. There are way more than I thought there were going to be. P-Hats can only be killed via... I believe when they stop spinning, that is the only time they are vulnerable. And that is the only time you can kill them. And seriously, none of those enemies dropped a life. What the hell? Don't want to go in there, but there is a secret way up here that leads into this area, which will give us more rupees. We must then turn around and we're going to go get a note for a potion shop. Oh, 100 rupees. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Why did I do that? Seriously, I'm really good at wasting my bombs. It's great. It's a force of habit. Really bad force of habit, too. Up here we go. And in here we'll find the note from the old man. Show this to the old woman. And now, if we show this to an old woman, we can get potions. Potions are very helpful, if you know your Zelda. And down we go. We're gonna have to go to the left here, so... Oh, ran straight into that. We've gotta go up here, Dev. And I think the enemies here are Tektites, so nothing too special. Nothing too dangerous, nothing too dangerous gets hit by a Tektite, dies from Tektite. That's because I'm really bad at this. I'm probably just gonna, like, jump cut to when I'm back there, so I will see you when I get back there. Alright, guys, I am back. And I'm not dealing with that. We're climbing up here again, back to where the Tektites were. Wait, is this the one we need to climb up? No, this is the one with the old man. It's the other one we need to climb up. Silly me. But yeah, we are back here now, and we're in a good position. Let's climb up here, leave the P-Hats alone. They can go fly on their own. And we have our sword beams. I managed to keep myself at full health. And legitimately, I don't think I lost any health. I can't remember. But I did pretty damn good to get back here. And I've just realized that I need more bombs. I'm on one bomb, and I'm gonna need more bombs. Because I'm about to bomb a wall. Oh, I don't need to bomb this wall. It's just open. That's great. That's perfect. I thought this was gonna be a bombable wall, and I'd have to bomb it, and I wouldn't have the bombs, and bad things, and sad things, and killed ya. In here, we can buy something called the Blue Candle, which basically lights things on fire. We need to buy it for 60 rupees, and then we need to head down here. We've still got over 140-something rupees, so we've got a lot of rupees. We can head down here, and we can go over this way. Now, going up here for about 3 times will get you to Dungeon 6, I believe, Dungeon 6 or 5, but we don't need to do that. We just need to go right, and we need to go up. You can also go into that waterfall over there, but I can't remember what it was for. Now we have to deal with a weird guy that knows how to use a sword beam. And packs a wallop. Oh my god, really? Really? I'm already dead? Okay guys, I'm back. We're just before that area with the creepy centaur guy, or whatever it is he is, and... This time, we're going to approach with more caution. Just quickly avoid the Zoro! God damn it, we're not going to avoid with caution. We're going to get beat up so badly. It's all the Zora's fault. The Zora just hit us right then, had to hit us then. What we need to do is we need to get that guy to... Nope, not happening. Don't go into the cave, that's cheating. That's cheatsy doodles. Let's head into the cave. Master using it, and you can have this. And we can have it. So now, I'm just gonna quickly scroll down my walkthrough. We've got some more secret rupees to find. Got some more stuff to do. We're gonna get another heart container and our shield. But first of all, we get to finish off this guy with our new sword. Like so. Totally worth it. Like a boss. Okay, so once we get down here, we'll want to take out some Tektites to get some health if we can. Oh, and I'm dead. If anything, though, being dead probably helps me more, because I didn't want to have to go through that area anyway. And we're probably closer going this way. Yeah, we're actually closer to where we want to be. I mean, we're going to go at the different places in different orders, and I just wasted my last bomb, but at least we're going somewhere. Let's just quickly kill these guys for some hearts, if we can. Because they tend to drop hearts more often than not. Obviously not today. It's a little annoying. It's a little silly. Oh, fairy. Come here, fairy. Come hither. Okay, kill you. Okay, we just need one heart. We literally need one heart. You didn't give me that heart. You're useless. Okay, we want to go up this way, and this is actually where we want to be. Now, we can finally put this candle to use. And I believe it's this one that we need to burn. It's either that one or it's that one. It's one of them we need to burn, and I don't know which one it is. I think it's the second from the top, and I did the third from the top by mistake. First from the top, okay. Go in here, some secret rupees. Now, we're going to head up and get some more rupees, because we're going to need them. And then we're going to just continue on our merry way like nothing ever happened. And get the fairy, and run. And we need to burn this one on the bottom right. I hope, I really hope, yes, I'm right. Okay. It's a secret to everybody, yep. You as well. Thanks for the rings. Oh, the rings, rupees. Lovely. I'm not playing Sonic. Oh, and I get... Because there's one weapon, or one item, that I cannot wait to get, which I'll be getting in a minute, which is going... Oh, not in a minute, in a little while. Possibly this episode, possibly next episode, one of them. Let's burn you, see if that opens up the stairway, because I know there's a stairway here. I don't know which one it is. This one? No. Oh, this is going to be... trial and error, man, trial and error. Okay, I think it may be the fifth or sixth one, so... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, somewhere around there. Come on, yes, there it is. We want to get another heart container, and then we're going to go and get a shield. We have seen shields before in shops, but we can get it cheaper where we're going. Because who wants a... who doesn't want a good bargain? There we go. And a shield for 90. 90 for a shield, that's perfect. Alright, now let's just quickly scroll down again, because that's the part end of this. We're going to get some secret rupees, some arrows, some red medicine, it's going to be fun. I don't know why we're going to need arrows, but the walkthrough just says, hey, you need the arrows. So, I'm going to go and get some arrows. So, I think there is a secret thing here. We've been in this area before. This is one of the lake areas that we usually started off in. Oh, that's really cool. This is an area we'd normally traverse, but now we actually have a reason to go here. That's actually really, really cool. I quite like that. Not you, then. It's one of them here. Oh, it's the one beneath it. That's the one that burns. Like so. I did not know that the fire could hurt you. That is something I should remember. Alright, now there was a shop that I actually saw while exploring a little while ago that it turns out I actually have to go to now, and I didn't think I'd need anything from it, how wrong I was. Ow. Stop hitting me. No, you can... Duh. Fairy, I need it. Okay, we need to go to the right here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna head to the right, and we're going to go up from here. We're gonna go up. And then we're gonna... Now, if you go up again, you will reach a fairy fountain. Fairy fountains are very helpful places, as you may or may not know, because they can heal you. And if you go to the right, you'll find the shop that I was looking for. The shop is awesome. I love the shop. It's great. It's great. It's great. Oh god, no, 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 no. These are just normal Tektites. They stay in place for longer, but they're still kind of spazzy. I wanted you too, aww. What we need to buy are the arrows. Now, there's actually no real reason for me to be buying the arrows. It just says it in the walkthrough, and I assume that it's a good thing. So we're gonna go buy the arrows, we're gonna head over here, and we're gonna head down. Now, one of these burns, and I'm pretty sure... If I just quickly go back in, it's this one here. Yes, it is. It's a secret to everybody. I've seen you so many times today, man. Like, you don't even need to hide your secrets from me. I know you. I know you, boo. Alright. Use the candle. Come on. Let me in. That actually took a little bit of time. That's kind of worrying. Bit of lag there. 100 rupees. Brilliant. And now we want to head left. Oh, this is the lake that we normally go on. Oh, I got it confused with another lake. Ah, okay, just leave the Octorox alone. We don't need to risk losing our sword beam. Not right now. Now, we actually do need to continue farming rupees because, there's gonna be an item soon that costs quite a lot of rupees that we're gonna need and we're gonna want. We're gonna need the rupees that we can get. Oh, I walked right into you. So every enemy is worth killing. As horrible as that sounds. Now, if we go down from here, we'll be right back at the very start of the entire place where we began, and I don't have any bombs on me. Oh no. I have no bombs. I can't get the secret rupees here, but I'll just remember them for next time. Maybe there are bombs in here that I can get. I don't know. Because if there are bombs, I'm going to buy them. No bombs, but there's a key, blue candle, shield. I already have all that stuff, so I don't need it again. Bombs would have been nice, but you know what? Sometimes enemies drop them, sometimes they don't. I feel like it's fate. No, it's completely not fate. I'm just bullcrapping myself here. We don't actually need to buy the potion, but like, it's a nice thing to have, if anything. Because there's a potion in this shop here that we can get, because we need to show the old... Oh, that's why, because we need to show the note to the old lady. That's probably what it needs us to do. Will we be actually buying potions now, though? Will we? Yeah, we will. If you'd like, you can buy a potion. I don't actually need to, but I can if I want. Okay. There you go. Now, I'm not going to buy a potion because I don't really need it at the moment. I don't think I will need it for a little while. And I kind of want to save up for my next item that we're going to go for, which is the blue ring. Which basically just, yes. The blue ring is needed. It is very much needed. Okay, we need to head down here. If we want to get the most out of the areas that we're going to the right will actually take us to a dungeon, I believe. Or at least it'll take us near enough to a dungeon. It's kind of cool. But no, we need to go this way, and I think we're gonna need bombs again, so let's see if we can kill these guys, see if we can get some bombs from them. Or something, I don't know, anything from them would be nice? No, no bombs, okay, that's fine. I'm not sure why they're not dropping bombs at the moment, though, it's kind of like something that you'd think was a given. Aha. And I freeze you all in time. So I can murder you and take all your stuff, yeah. Okay, so we can't get the secret rupees in there. I don't know how many rupees are actually in there because, as I said, following a walkthrough. So we need to burn you. Look at that. How many rupees have we got? Because we need 250 rupees in order to get the blue ring. And I have no- Oh, we've got the money. We have the money. We have all the monies. Come on. Bombs! Yes! Okay, what we're gonna do is we are going to head back down and get the secret rupees from over here first, just because we've got bombs now and we can do that. So let me just put bombs out as my B button. Oh, you guys would spawn there. You would spawn there. You would. You would. We need to head down here. We need to head through here. What? Oh, please don't tell me I've got myself trapped. Okay, I guess I have to go to the right then. Oh no. Alright, let me guess, the only way you can leave this way is by going right. Yep, think that's it. So what we need to do is we need to go this way, and then down this way, and then we'll come back around and we can go and get those rupees that we missed, because every rupee helps and I really don't want to have to pay out a lot of money when I'm gonna need it later on. Plus, who doesn't want rupees? Right, I think it's about here. What? Oh, it's about here. Awkward. Okay, and more secret rupees. It better not be for like 10 rupees, because I'm gonna be really annoyed otherwise. 30 rupees, and why did I not get rupees from that? Please don't tell me I've reached my limit. That would be really bad for me. That would be really bad. I'm just gonna have to go and buy the blue ring now because I think I've reached my limit on rupees. I don't know. It never gave me the rupees, so I assume that I've probably reached a limit. Is it possible to reach a limit on this game for rupees? I don't know. So I'm just gonna head off, get the blue ring now. If we need more rupees, then we know where to go. And once I've got the blue ring, we're allowed to go to dungeon one. Which will be even more fun. So let's head off over here. Not this area here. We need to go up. We need to move you. Kill you guys. I think it's this one. That is weird. That is kind of messed up. This one? Maybe. No. You. Oh god, I'm dead. No, that's not good. Where's the blue ring location? Come on. I moved that one. I have no idea what's happened. What? Looking at the walkthrough, it says that I was at the right place and I was pushing the right area, and it just wasn't letting me get the cave open. So I think there was a little bit of a glitch there, so we're gonna have to go and fix that. Because I need that blue ring. That blue ring, which is what I'm gonna get. It halves damage done by everything. And, well, I need that in my life. It'll make the dungeon so much easier. Skills, though, I have skills. Alright, what we want to do is we want to go this way, and I think it's... Let's deal with you, get that. Screw you. Just like, screw you. We want to go up. Then we want to go up again. I think. No, that leads to dungeon 7. No, we want to go left. And then we want to go up here. Do we want to go up? No. That's... No, we want to go right. Like, I've completely lost my way at this point. We want to go right, and then we want to go right again. Okay. I got it. Here we are. And I just killed that Zora. Deserved it. Really deserved it. Alright, let's kill that Octorok there. Okay, that Octorok's gonna hurt me instead. And I get hit by another Octorok just as I get my heart back. Okay. I think this is just like all the blue enemies. It's just like, shh, hinting at the blue ring. Hush. There's the thing that was meant to pop up before. And now we've got to wait for the man to appear. There he is. Let's get ourselves a blue ring. And now that we have the blue ring, we can head to dungeon 1. But we're going to be doing that in the next episode. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk over to dungeon 1 because I do know my way there. And then we're going to continue on the next episode when going into the actual dungeon, and I need to stop bombing the floor because the force of habit. Off this way. Down we go. Have to go across this bridge again. No choice. We've got to do it. Now, if you want to get to dungeon 4, you can go across that little raft thing there, but we don't actually need to do that, so we're going to be fine. We've already been here, as you can evidently see. All we need to do here is go up, and then go left. And because we don't need to go up and left, we need to go right, and then right again, and then up, and then left. That's what we have to do. And we're so much more OP than any normal person would be when they play this map, and those guys I don't think normally spawn there. I just like how now we can kill Octoroks in just one hit. It's beautiful. I mean, I'm still getting bashed around, but like the fact that you can just kill Octoroks in one hit is just brilliant. Let's deal with this one Octorok here. And come on, come over here, there you go. And in the next episode, guys, we will be continuing where we face on the Eagle's Dungeon. So, I'll be seeing you next time. Goodbye.